In the beginning, God created. As the creator of everything, he shaped and formed the heavens above and the earth below where his favor rested. This is God's story. And it all began with royal declarations spoken by God. This is the word of God. Imagine utter darkness, an empty void of space, nothingness. It was blindingly dark over the great depths that were waiting for God's command and anticipating his breath of life. God's spirit danced and lingered over the black, gloomy waters. Envision God's Holy Spirit encircling you, watching over you, and breathing life into you. Let his spirit move freely in your life. Ask Jesus to calm your spirit and open your heart to receive his word and truth. Listen to the music and hear God speak life into you. God spoke, "Let there be light." And by his powerful and mighty word, there was light, a brilliant, magnificent light that revealed God's glory and separated itself from darkness. And as he looked over his fulfilled command, God was pleased, so very satisfied and inspired. He beamed with delight over his creation and named the light day and the darkness night, day and night. Each welcomes the other at just the right time, directed by God. But it was evening that gave way to the morning. This was the first day of God's vision of creation. With God's great pleasure, he spoke again. Waters above, part from the waters beneath you. Let there be a wide and vast canopy in between the two waters. Part. And part they did, just as God commanded. God again separates and divides, this time to the water. God named this great dome-like space sky. Evening, once again, welcomed the morning. Day two was successful and fulfilling. With his ultimate creation in mind, God gazed down upon the depths of the water and began mapping out the details and architectural design of the earth. As with all purposes of God, it involved great planning and preparation. As another day approached, God spoke to the abyss. Waters under heaven, gather together. bring forth dry land. God thoughtfully named his new creation, earth. The gathered waters he named sea. With great delight, God continued to provide tender, nurturing care to the earth and sea. He spoke again. Earth, spring to life with lush vegetation, seed-bearing plants and trees. And just as God instructed, it was done. Each variety marries and merges to create more of its kind, just as it should be. And just as God purposed, night gave way to morning at the appropriate time. Day 3 was eventful as the earth showed its first signs of life. God saw that it was beautiful, and he was very pleased.